Live. It's live. It's live. Hey, Mike. How's it going, Mike? Bulls and barbecue. Charles Roberts, hello. Hey, Paul. Yeah, we're trying it downtown. I'm actually in a no parking spot, so this may be a pretty exciting video if they come down here and bust my nuggets. Yeah,
you're supposed to drive down here.
He'll be back. He's hammering in some rod holders here. It's all rock. Hi, Brian B. We got some waves. Wildcat Rig says, Dan, I hope you are not using your vice grip crimped rig today, LMAO. I'll be back.
Or read the chat. Good morning.
We're getting there. Okay, here we go. Million bridges. Yeah. There's not a million here, only a couple. Who else is in here? Wildcat. No, I'm in Wilkes Barre. Who asked me that? River Boys, yeah, I'm in Wilkes Barre. Wilkes Barre. That's the Market Street Bridge in front of me. There's the city on the other side of that bridge. Yeah, you can see the city. You can still see my rods. Okay. Be all right like that. As long as my camera don't blow over. Eh, there we go. Where are you? From the area. I'm at the Susquehanna River in Wilkes-Barre. And like I said, I'm parked where you shouldn't be. So this might become an interesting video if they come down here and start yelling at me for parking on the side of the river. River's low, there was room, so I did it. Yeah, this is the Market Street Bridge in Wilkes-Barre. Going into the city from Kingston. I'm on the Kingston side. Believe it or not, you see where the river is now. When they had the flood, the river was up over the top of that bridge. That's how far up this river went. Yeah, this isn't very wide. I don't know, maybe a quarter mile tops. It's got some good depth and it's got current. It always has current here. Depth wise, oh, I know it's 20 some foot on the other side of the bridge. I think it's probably 16 in the middle here. Oh, you look 2 miles from Accomack. Yeah, I was just down there, Marietta, not too long ago. They're having a tournament this weekend down at Aldred. Yeah, no, it's Wilkes-Barre. I'm on a north branch. That's why it's so skinny. Like I said, when we had our flood, it went right up over top of that bridge that you see. When the river hit 41 feet. I think right now the river's at 2 feet. I didn't check it. I think it's 2 foot right now, so. Yeah, it went up 39 feet from where it's at. I'm actually in between two bridges. Behind me is the Pierce Street Bridge, and in front of me is the Market Street Bridge. See, like the PNC building over there and stuff. I guess you can still get the crowds. You fished Goldsboro from the bank at the launch? Or did you have a boat? On the bank, it'll be real tough. If I was fishing the bank, I'd fish down Long Level on the bank. We're in Wrightsville. I wouldn't fish Goldsboro from the bank. Oh, at the launch, yeah. A couple years ago, when I did a tournament there, we got the biggest channel cat, and we also got the biggest flathead. And that was at their August tournament. NJ, I just set up here. We're here 18 minutes. We're here 18 minutes, pal. 18. And it took me 10 minutes to pound the rod holders in the rock. But the fish count will be more than yours today.
I don't know. I'm like iffy with this spot. This is one of my favorite. Like, I like.
Yeah, there's a lot of good bank spots. Even the Marietta boat launch is a really good bank spot. But Falmouth is real good. I like Falmouth. Yeah, that's like 125 miles from where I am now. It's a 2-hour trip for me, a little over 2 hours to get down there. This weekend, I'm trying to get down to Aldred and fish. There's carp here, but not right where I'm at. I'm kind of in a deeper section. But there is carp if I went over to the shallow stuff to my left, upstream a half mile. It's pretty shallow and pretty muddy. This is more like a rocky. Lots of channel cats, lots of big channel cats. Possibility for a flathead. She might. She got the first two rods. I got the second two. She got the two white rods. I got the yellow and the blue. And we got good bait. Real good bait today. Last time I fished this was in the fall, and we got a 9-pound channel cat right here. Actually, the river was up, and I got it up. I was up on top of the bank. Hey, 351, what's up? Yeah, I'm in a no parking, but you would have to drive all the way down the end of the ramp to find me, so.
Yeah, all you gotta do is walk up on top and just flashlight.
Yeah, well I'm only gonna fish till 9 o'clock. Actually I could fish longer because the lights on the bridge will be all on. It's pretty bright here at night. This is like our city spot up here anyhow on this branch. I don't know where they are. I think I'm.
Switch off somewhere.
Oh well, battery goes dead. I'll just have to get a jump start. New Jersey said hello. Hey,
hi,
guess
MJ.
What? Guess what she has?
I'm using my bag.
Show them. She's got her bag. Hang on. Hang on, Jersey.
I switched it over.
There's the bag. All her stuff's in it.
I love it. I'm organized now. Stay out of my bag, Stan.
I got my own bag. I don't need your bag.
I found some of my stuff in your tackle box. I took it back.
No. Nah.
I did.
Everything is mine. You just borrow it.
Nope. Well.
Yeah, well, instead of going to the catwalk there, just go to the other dam and go on that one. On the, I don't know what they call it, safe harbor. Go to safe harbor and fish off the concrete there. That's a really good spot, safe harbor. On Facebook, they have a group, Safe Harbor Fishing. You always see guys pulling up 30, 40-pound flatheads. Yeah, that's fine. But not on a weekend. It's got to be a weekday. Weekends are tough. I'm always busy on weekends. And I'm probably going to be going back to work in July, so I only have this month to play. Yeah, a weekday would be real good. You just gotta let me know what day, because I still got a bunch of appointments I gotta go to. Yeah, but Safe Harbor's 100 times better than York Haven Catwalk. Trust me on that. 100 times better. I don't know if you're in the group, the Safe Harbor group. If not, get on it in Facebook and take a look. You'll see. Yeah, unless we do a Sunday. You know, Sunday would be a good day to do it. Got to check the weather and stuff. I know, like, it. My weather said it's going to rain every day until next week, so.
Wednesday.
And Wednesday, I got appointments. I have appointments tomorrow and Wednesday. AC, what do you need AC for? Hey, Rustic, what's going on? Oh, thanks for sharing me. Thank you. Yeah, I kind of knew I was going to go live. I just really didn't know what time. Because this isn't my first pick for spots. I was going to go to a different spot, but the other spot is like a half a mile walk. I just didn't feel like walking it. I know if we get one here, it'll be a good takedown. It's all good. Really, Jersey? Stan who? Fourteen years ago, you were what, in second grade? Yeah, you got to check all your subs because you know how YouTube is. It gets weird. I had to resub to a few people too. Also, you better check your mods too on your own channel because they go in there and they take away mods away from you. That's it. What about Gut Road, River Boys? You know Gut Road? Going good, Dave. How you doing, Dave? Thirteen people, all right. Not bad for a Monday. It's today, Monday, right? I guess it's Monday. Like solid rock on this bank. I'm surprised they even got those rod holders to go in. Next time I'll make sure I have my hammer here so I didn't have to beat them in with a wrench. More people fishing behind you. Well, that guy wasn't out very long. It looked like he was bass fishing.
Oh, he's bass
fishing. Get what, Jersey? What did I forget this time? You.
No, you do it. You did it.
I didn't know what you're talking about. Yeah. It's kind of windy. At least it's not like unbearably hot. I think I saw it was like 78 degrees, but it's a nice breeze, and I'm in the shade. I should pull the fuse for those lights, and they won't be on.
Hi.
Hey. I'm in Wilkes-Barre, Jersey, Wilkes-Barre. Wilkes-Barre, PA, North Branch. It's like the only city on the river, on this section of the river. Yeah, I'm at the end of 84, then get on 81 and go south. Wilkes-Barre. And they kind of made it nice. On the other side, on the city side, they have a park they built. A lot of people come down here and fish. They're mostly people fishing for bass, though. I'm probably the only guy fishing for catfish. This is like 30 minutes from my house. They're half an hour. I live 30 minutes south up here. It's not really that bad of a drive. It's all highway too. Yeah, it's a good view here at night. Once they get all the lights on, it looks pretty cool. Come on. We'll be hooking up here soon. This is a decent spot. Don't forget, Jersey, we're fishing a river. We're not fishing a little pond or a lake. Oh,
They're leaving, see?
This is the one place I hate launching my boat, because the ramp is like super steep.
Yeah, I like this.
This ramp is so steep. That one's steep too. Yeah, I always have that feeling that the e-brake will let loose and the truck will go in neutral and goodbye everything. Everything will wind up in the river.
You almost did that one.
Almost lost my Jeep in the river. Are you reading the chat? No, she wasn't reading the chat right now. Wait, is there a message? Oh, hello, Elaine. Just seeing if we can catch some fish.
Oh, that one out. What'd you do?
Nothing.
You did something to make it glow.
Magic. I said lights glow. No, maybe
your glow was an open. It must have been open. All you did was sit down.
Yeah. Lights out, and they went out. See, I'm a magician.
No, you did it.
I didn't do anything.
You're out. That's a good thing.
Magic.
Yeah, the battery's completely dead.
Oh, magic. Look at the tape measure. Tape measure.
I know it's in there. Leave it there.
You know, I want to measure my brain.
I don't have anything that small.
That makes all the difference.
Can you guys hear those church bells going off?
Church is in session.
No, but I have a turkey hoagie that I'm going to go after here in a few minutes. Jersey, you call it a hoagie, or are you a grinder boy? Is it a grinder for you, or is it a hoagie? No, they're the bells that'll be playing when I'm pushing daisies. They'll be playing those bells for me. That must have been the 6 o'clock bells. Hoagie or a hero. Where'd I get grinder from? Where's grinders? Someplace I was, they call it a grinder. I forget where.
Hello. I have to move the lunch for last time.
Never heard of grinder. Oh, that's right. You're just a little kid yet. I keep forgetting, thinking that you're older like me.
Grinder's not a sandwich. Grinder's a hoagie too. Didn't think where it was. Maybe it was in North Carolina they call it a grinder. See, Jersey, how I interact with the chat. This is what you got to do. You got to interact with your chat, with the people who are watching. You interact with them. You talk. You pretend to be nice. It's easy. Hey, I'm live.
No bites yet.
I'm live. Yeah, no bites yet. We're still trying.
Want to sit down? I can't sit back.
Yeah, let him sit there.
It hurts to sit. It hurts to stand.
I tell you what.
You like how I parked down here? You like how I parked right down here? Yeah, move that net. Yeah, there's two more people down underneath the bridge fishing. They walked. You can almost see them. They're on the other side. Yeah, I think they're fishing for bass.
Yeah, there's bass time. Supposed to rain tomorrow.
The next, I think, the whole week.
I hope not. So Wednesday, they said chance.
Yeah, Wednesday.
There's a chance of rain every day this week.
But I think Wednesday.
I'll tell you what, Stan, I tried everything. I got a dial tone on my phone now, too.
So it's still not like
I got a message from Verizon. They text me and they said, we think we fixed.
All right, I'm back. We're listening to stories. That last one was an R-rated story.
But we have a story.
What's your story?
I went golfing on Saturday, last Saturday. And I always wear shorts. I have these old shorts I had for a couple of years.
No, I gotta see where this is going.
I'm gonna golf 18 holes. So we all agreed to stop by Tips and Turtle. You know, have a bite to eat, have a beer.
Yeah.
So walk in the place or diner. Now I'm sitting all the way down at the end of the table. We're bullshit carrying on. And I tell you what, my buddies sent the menu down. I said, "Dave, I'm not going to eat anything. I just came by to have a beer. That's all here. I think you better take this menu." He says, "Look down between your legs." I did. When I did, my penis was sticking out. I think with these shorts split wide open, and I didn't even know that I was sitting there in the
waiting
room taking the order with food order and everything. I know it's so embarrassing.
Oh, right, man. Like,
yeah, always should tuck your penis in it, the Tipsy Turtle. I'll remember that. There we go. I just lost about 5 subs.
No, we didn't. That's funny.
No points yet. But we're only here 51 minutes, so we'll see. I didn't feel like walking down 44.
Anyway, you have to get up and go, right?
Yeah, I didn't feel like walking that hill.
It's gonna take a while.
I didn't even feel like walking this hill. That's why I parked here.
Surgery.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that ain't my fault. I'm taking off the twist off the arms.
How you doing? Yeah, we're live on YouTube.
Oh, cool. How you doing?
Not yet. How about you?
Nope.
I think they're being stubborn.
Any bites or anything?
No. I just gotta go in the morning, you know? I think that's a problem.
Yeah.
I don't know. I caught a fish by accident last night.
Hey, all you can do is try.
I can't beat the amount of money they put in that cluster.
Yeah, nobody even fishes there or uses it or nothing, really.
Nope.
You can see just how low the river is right now. That whole thing's sticking out.
I tell you, I'm going to go down here and metal detect.
You should have brought it.
Up there with
oh, all these banks. You probably find all kinds of fishing lures and everything.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's where the Indians were. Supposedly they had gold coins. Jeremy was tucking down there. No ways down.
Yeah.
He found this, looks like a stamp, a metal stamp that you put on a piece of wax to seal a envelope.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what, he never got it. Nobody ever knew what it was.
No.
But it was old. It was,
it was like
17, 18,
a cuff link or something. Or for your shirt.
Yeah, it had some kind of a dragon design on it.
Till 7:30, yeah. Yeah, you got to go to bed early. Deliver your bread.
I got to show you that rod that I got.
These are
old rods.
Okay,
but
something like this, but that's a wooden.
Yeah, wooden.
Oh, wooden fishing rod?
A
wooden fishing rod?
No, I tell you what. It's fiberglass like that, but
oh.
I tell you what.
I have one that's all wood.
Yeah.
Okay, here, all the way down, this beautiful wood.
Yeah, from the 60s. But I have one that's octagon. All the way up, the whole thing is wood.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I got that at the flea market. I had it. It was real neat looking.
Shit.
Well, I'll tell you what, my buddy, I got a text message from Dave today.
Oh, yeah.
He went to the service. He was already cremated. They had an urn.
Uh-oh. Ding, ding, we have a winner. What's the winner?
Who's the winner?
I don't know. Who's the winner? Porky Chop. What's up, Porky? Look at I'm on the bank. I'm not catching crap. But I'm on the bank.
Yeah, mix oil with it. Yeah. No, he didn't know about the shifter. You push the button and then you can high rev it. You push the button so it's not in gear. Which it sounds like he's doing it now.
So you helped him get it going.
Yeah.
Yeah, he rebuilt the carburetor and stuff on it. I don't know. It kind of acts like there's something not right with it.
You got to take it.
Nah, I rebuilt my tilt and trim. It works good.
Well, that's you.
No, I had my sound off before. Can you hear me now? Yeah, you got. Yeah. Yeah, I muted it when it was real windy. So it sounds like it's only running on one cylinder. Right? The two-cylinder motor?
Yeah.
Only one spark plug working right now. Probably has a fouled out plug. I'm surprised we're not getting nothing. See that pork chop? Good thing I came here. Now I know not to come here Thursday.
It's where it's muddy. You want to be.
Well, we could pack up and go to another spot. I have a couple more spots to try. It's not like it's hard to pack up. I'm 5 feet from the rods. Here, inspect on my chat. I'm going to go talk to this guy and tell him what I think.
Dad, I have a beer if you want a Corona. Hi, Crazy Hillbilly. No, I'm saying hi.
I'm gonna go fish.
What would Lance say? Wait a minute, I gotta go back and read this one.
I gotta.
What the hell's a crumble cookie? I want to know what a crumble cookie is and why you're in a line for it. I can hear you. What is a crumble cookie? I want to know what this is. Yeah, Lance said something about a crumble cookie. That must be like a Wisconsin thing. Wisconsin, you should be eating cheese. Ain't that where cheese is from? There you go. Buy a thing of cookies, sit on them, and you'll have crumble cookies. Make your own. Pork chop, you must have gave me bad luck. Where's the fish at? He definitely gave me bad luck. I always catch fish. And it's not a boat thing either. I catch fish no matter where I am. See, our weather pattern changed there. We got that cold front. I think we're still going to catch a fish, though.
Joyce got
it. We'll have to go down and hit that mud spot.
And I have water. Oh, you're
I think I'm 53. Oh, I'm born in 68. You got to figure it out. Hey, Hogleg, what's up? How are you doing? We're trying some fishing in the city. We're in Wilkes-Barre, PA, right at the river. That's the city you see in the background. We're here an hour and 11 minutes and we didn't get a bite yet. Oh, we gotta get the battery pack out. Oh, I forgot something. I forgot to charge the phone.
literally.
Here's the best battery pack you can get yourself. All it is an 18 volt. This is a rigid battery.
Rigid.
And then you get this USB adapter. Bam. Now you got yourself a real good USB adapter battery pack, 18 volt, 60 amp hour. That's all there is to it. Good old eBay. See what's charging. Yep. Yeah. He's working. He said he just rebuilt his carburetor and he just did a tune-up on it, all kinds of stuff he did to it. I think this is working. Around 8%, so. Unplug it. Plug it in. Yep, it's charged.
Right down there.
$295. Or does that say $29? No, this was a little bit more. This was like $40 for the adapter and the battery. But I could probably go 24 hours on that battery.
Oh, I'm having a turkey hoagie.
Turkey hoagie on a wheat bun. Yeah, it's only 7. I'll stay here till 9, see what happens. There's channel cats in here.
I got another spot a mile up river. But like I said, you got to walk. You probably got to walk almost a half a mile to get to the spot. Today I was lazy. I didn't feel like walking. So I'm sitting right next to my car. I got the car right on the riverbank. Are you sure you're in New Jersey? It's Wawa, not Wasa, Wawa. I mean, there's a lot of Turkey Hills here, but there's like sheets getting built everywhere. Well, you know, it's $5.25 a gallon here right now. That is a terrible bite today. Where's Brian B? In here? Brian B? J&J, how you doing? We're trying to catch Channel Cat. Fishing downtown Wilkes-Barre, Susquehanna River, Pennsylvania. All right, I'm back. Jersey takes longer than 16 hours. I drove a tow truck back from Wisconsin. Took me 24 hours. But I can only go 50 bucks. That was La Crosse, Wisconsin. That's where I drove back from. J&J, whereabouts on the Susquehanna? I'm up in Wilkes-Barre right now on the North Branch. Where do you fish it? Pork chop, you bring that crap in here, I'm going to throw you right off the stream. You better get your lipstick ready and pucker up. Pucker up, pork chop. No, it's not on fire. You caught one fish there in 3 months. That's not called on fire. New spot. It better not be a Pelag. This isn't the Potomac, so you don't get a bite, you know, every 15 seconds. You got to wait for them here. But when you do get them, you'll get 2, 3, 4 in a row. So we're just waiting on that first bite. That's how this river runs. Yeah, it's just once you catch that first one, then you'll catch 2, 3, 4 in a row, you know, or within 30 minutes, you'll keep catching. They turn on, they turn off. This spot should turn on right before dark. Like I said, it's only 6:45 now, so I expect by 8:30 we'll have fish. I really think by 7:30 I'm going to have fish. I'm glad it's going to go from 6 to 9. Six to seven, you know, I never catch many fish from 6 to 7. 7 to 8, 8 to 9, yeah, that's better times. Yeah, that's a Hills, that holder that you see, that's a Hills holder. But what I did was I put it on a threaded rod. It's a solid steel rod, but a thread at the end of it. And then use a double female connector. I can get in closer and show it to you. Let me see. I'm only on 11%. I'll get a picture of it and send it to you. Ugly. But yeah, it's a Hills rod holder. On that first rod. The other rods, I don't think you can see them, but they're the green springs. Hey, you can probably see it now. They're green spring rod holders. They're from Rippin' Lips. Those other ones. There, I think we're straight now. Yeah, it's like a homemade thing I did, Hog Lake. I went to a steel shop and I said I need steel rod and thread the end of it. I said, I need three of them made. Wait, actually, I got another one here in the car. Yeah, here's one here. That's the Hills. This one I bent it a little bit. You see there? That's a double male. So the rod holder screwed into it. And then this is my steel rod threaded. That's about, I don't know, it's a 3-foot rod. But I paid way too much for them. Those rods were like $20 a piece. I wish there was Arthur Treacher's up here. They got rid of them all. All that's left is Long John Silver's. I might stop there. That's a good place.
I like Long John.
Should be getting a bite soon here. Up to 12% now.
Yeah, down in Maryland.
What the steel rods hog like? I got those at a regular metal shop. They're $20 a rod. Well, I think they were $15, but I think the guy charged me $5 a rod to thread it for me. I know Hills makes a bait rod holder, but it's not, you know, it's not 3 foot tall, and it's not, that's a half inch rod. But I'm pounding in through a rock right now here. Huh? Yeah. And there's guys down that way, and there's people up this way. I think there's a porta live up on top here. I don't know if that was a bite or not. Yeah, that's a bite on a white rod. White rod right behind you. Watch it. No, just let it go. Biting though. Yeah. There he goes again. You're getting a peck. Watch out, pork chop, that's our first bite. See that? 10 minutes to seven. 8 minutes to seven. Three times it was pecking at it. That wasn't wind. No, it was definitely a fish. It was short and violent. You know, it was the wind is. Could have been a turtle pecking at it, even. Yeah, it might have been a turtle. Pecking like a turtle. Hey, Andy. How you doing, Andy? We're just starting to get our first little action here. First signs of life. You'll know when I get one on, though, because that rod will really bend here. They bend over good. Hey, 922, how you doing? It is very windy. It's a good 10-15 mile an hour wind right now. Right now it's a good 10 mile an hour wind. So we'll see. Go ahead, you're mod. Drop them. You guys, whoever's blue, whoever's a mod, you can drop any link you want. I don't care. I hope that fish comes back. Hey, it's Trey rubbing the rods. I don't know. That's what Curtis does. He rubs the rods and then he gets a bite.
Like a genie.
Yeah. And to give them luck. Yeah, I think there's one up on the top up there. There has to be, because they have ornaments here and everything. Oh, is that what he wants? Yeah, I don't know how to do that. Yeah, he wants to go inhale his pasta. I mean, I could probably figure out how to put the link up there. You asked an hour ago. Where was I? I must have been helping that guy try to get his boat started. When you asked. There was a guy here, he couldn't get his boat started. I went over there and helped him out, and he got it running, but it was only running on one cylinder. I think he has a fouled-out spark plug. He went down that way in the bushes. He went to pay the parking meter.
I have to pay the parking meter too. I have to pee so bad.
Walk down there past him and see what's in those bushes. Watch out for the rattlesnakes.
I don't care about snakes.
There's snakes and moccasins. And...
oh my God.
I can't believe they don't have a portal lab up there.
I'd rather pee outside than go on it.
We'll go down there in the bushes. Just don't sit on poison ivy.
Remember I did the itch weed?
Yeah.
I had to sit in the river?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, I must have missed it. I would have had you come up if you wanted to. Then I'd have to come up on yours. Here, I think I see the link on the top of my phone here. That should be the link. If you got a pen, I'll read it off to you, and you can try it. See if this is the link. Let me know if you have a pen. Well, you saw her channel, yeah. Yeah, she grabs the turtles. I do the camera. I do the camera and I pull the kayak, because after you catch the turtles, we put them in a feed bag, a burlap bag, and then we put the turtle in the kayak. I don't know. It says, that's my father-in-law. It says StreamYard.com. Then it has a forward slash. Then it says Y37TB. JJA58. That's what it says. That might be the link. I don't know. Did you get that? Y37TBJJA58. Who's mean?
Let's spell.
Go ahead, try it. I'll see if you come in. God, how do you do that? Let me see here. I just touched it to copy it and it shot me off. Let's see. Yes. Copy. Am I still here? Okay, I got it copied. Now let me see if I can figure out how to do a comment. I don't know how to do a comment. Okay, post comment. Please. Yeah. There. Here's the link. I guess it's wrong. Hang on a second. Let me mute the mic. I have no idea what I'm doing. Let me see.
Okay, I'm back again. I have no clue what I'm doing here. More. Private chat. Paste. Boom. Oh, I put it in the wrong chat. I'm back again. Still trying to figure out how to post a comment. More. Post comment. Paste. Chat.
I still can't believe I did that by myself. I put that.
Oh my god, I think I got it. Try that one. I only kicked myself out 6 times to post that. And it's the same, and it's the same one that I told you before. I told you, get a pen. Why don't you just get a pen? All you had to do was get a pen. I didn't have to go through all that crap. You should buy a pen. It's easier to just read it to you, and you write it down, and then you type it in and go. Where are you? Are you coming in, or did I do all that for nothing? Telling me that I just did that 4 times, kicked myself out 4 times, and now you're not even going to come in? Hogleg, hit that link. Come on in. I'm not even going to let Jersey in here. If he comes in, I'm just going to kick him out. You can come in, Hogleg. So you're really going to eat dinner now after I just did that 4 times. Kicked myself out of my stream 4 times to find a link to post it, and now you're not coming in. That's it. Next time, you just guess the link. All right, it's a guessing. You just guess what it is, and then if you get it right, I'll let you in. Who's gone? Am I gone? I should be right here. It says I'm live. I shouldn't be gone. So I don't care if you're eating on here. Just eat. Eat on here. Put up your icon. Or I don't care. You can eat on here. I didn't see any rules saying that you couldn't eat. Is that in the YouTube manual? You can't eat when you're live? I don't know. I should have brought down another water with me. I got a gallon of water in that antifreeze jug, but it might have had a little bit of antifreeze in it. That just gives it extra flavor. It'll be all right. Yeah, give me flavor. I can't stand water. Is this the only flavor you brought with you? Give me that one. I don't want that orange crap. That's strawberry watermelon. There we go. Strawberry watermelon. That should be good in my water. You're not telling my doctor nothing.
baby out.
Yeah. There, look at that.
Yeah, there you go.
Strawberry watermelon.
Does it taste like watermelon?
Yeah. Here, go ahead, take a swig of it. Oh. I didn't touch it yet.
No, that's all right.
Just don't give me no backwash.
I take your word.
Don't over squirt it because then it gets real strong. I made this one kind of strong. Tastes like Kool-Aid. You gotta shake it up. If you need more, you put more in. You just adjust it to how you like it. Better than just drinking plain water. What the hell you talk about, MYO? This is Dollar General Clover Valley crap water, purified water. All right, pork chop, you watch it any minute now. One of these rods is going to get slammed. I got a feeling. I got a feeling. And you watch pork chop, it ain't going to be no little 3-pound fish like you catch. He's going to be the big mama's here. I feel it, pork chop. I feel it. It's coming. Squeal like a pork chop. Squeal like a pork chop. It's coming. I can hear the banjo. Squeal like a pork chop. Is that a bite?
I'm seeing a jerk.
Oh, that's a bite. Come on, you jerk. Jerk it again. Oh, if I get up before you, I'm going to get it. Getting jerky with us here. Got a little jerk going on. Watch out, pork chop. Starting to jerk. Jerk around here. Getting jerky. That's two bites now in 15 minutes that they're starting to come around. They'll be here soon. They're on their way. They're telling their people. They'll be here. Oh, I'm going to catch something.
we're starting to see some signs of life here. I got a feeling. Got a good feeling about this. That rod was just jerking. It was jerking it the right way. We're going to get one. Oh, there's a jerk. I just saw a little tap, tappy tap. Yeah, the link's up there. You just got to find it. Find the link and come on up. Get on the river. Come on up. I'm going to be here till 9 o'clock. So you still got almost 2 hours, 1 hour 45 minutes. I'll be on yet. You can come up and fish. That's fine. Where are you at? York Haven? You live in York Haven? Yeah, something keeps hitting that rod. You can feel it on there. You feel it? You feel it?
I can't feel my leg right now.
Are you feeling anything? Let it sit. Let it sit. Yeah, it's a homemade job. I gotta weld something on it, though, like a tab, so I can have something to beat with a hammer. Beat them down in the ground. Yeah, I don't particularly care for fishing from the bank either, you know, especially when I have like 6 boats at the house. But I've caught my share of fish from the bank. Not on a pontoon. Yeah, chlorine went way up in the price, didn't it, this year?
No.
Double in price?
$150 I just paid down on once. 25-pound.
How much was it last year for that amount? Or 2 years ago?
$7.
Yeah? So double in price.
I'll tell you what. I'm not getting a strong chlorine reading either. I don't know if it's Clorox. That's a brand name. 95%.
All right, go ahead. Let's see what you got. Grab the link. Go down the river. Set up. Come on in.
Got that storm. That's all the difference.
I'm sure we'll get one here. All right. I still feel it, though. We're going to get one
or two.
Guaranteed. It's coming. See, this is when it starts to get good now, right? Right now, almost 7:30. Between now and dark. If we don't get one here between now and 9, I ain't coming back here again. Seven twenty-one. I'm going to check my baits because I haven't checked them since I threw them out. So the baits are out there for 2 hours. I guess I better check them. I'm going to check all the baits in 2 hours.
Yeah, I know.
We still got bait. Yeah, I'd love to be at Accomack right now and have a live bluegill on. Love to do that. I wish it wasn't 125 miles away. So we'll see what happens here. Now they're all cast back out. Let me see. I'm gonna lift this up a little bit.
Yeah, I called.
There, now you can see the rod tips for the big smashing takedown that we're gonna have. That should work. I have a feeling I'm going to get one, pork chop. I got a good feeling about this. Okay. All right, River Boys.
The bottom one.
See, I wondered about my charger. When I put it on, it was on, really on 7%. The phone was on it. Now it's on 20. Yeah, when I fish down by Accomack, I like fishing right where the wildcat dumps out. You know the Wildcat Creek? Right where that dumps out. That's the spot I like to sit at. But I really think I should redo those two rigs on the first two poles. They're not done right.
One of the guys that golfed with Richard Thompson. Or he had forced.
Let's see here. Bump in the tripod.
Yeah, go right. There's a guy there on a mud.
Almost 7:30. Anytime now. We'll see what happens, Pork Chop. We'll see what happens. We're trying. Oh, hang on a second. Hang on. Oh, okay. Now it's working. We back. Yeah, you're right, I do. I got an hour and a half.
I would brag.
So we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
I think something good's going to happen. Last hour and a half. Okay.
See you, buddy.
All right.
Good luck.
I love you, Dad.
Yeah, I love you, too.
Thanks for stopping down.
You take care of yourself. Start drinking water. All
right? Yell at him. Tell him water.
Right there. My water.
All right. Well, long as you drink it.
2 liters a day, tell him.
Yeah, at least.
All right, I gotta tie these rigs right on her rod.
Her rigs aren't even right.
My scissors.
Oh, we're going to tie the rig the right way, not the way she had it. I'm tying your rig the right way.
I like my rig for the aftermarket.
Yeah, I was wrong.
That's why I got bites.
That's why you didn't get fish. Thank you. Okay, now we got 300. Just tying a rig. You guys are wondering what I'm doing, tying up her rig because she didn't have it right. Thank you. Okay, this one's ready to go back out. There, now they're rigged right, and they're out far. Yeah, I hope I catch something too. So we went from the 90s here last week to now it's like, you know, in the 70s. And cold front came through. So it's supposed to stay in the 70s all week, so I'm sure later on in the week it'll be a lot better. John Parker, hello, how are you? No fish yet. Couple of bites. But now we're getting to that real good time of the day. So we'll see what happens. Yeah, you keep track of the time for me, Pork Chop. That helps me a lot. Real windy here today, too, though.
Hey, close that door.
That door.
The one that's open?
I'll leave it open then. Hey, Eddie. Trying to catch a fish here. Look at that change in the weather. Has them a little messed up.
Chesapeake Bay, what's going on? No, it's that weather change, I think, got these fish all messed up. The good thing is the weather's going to stay the same all week, you know, in the 70s, not the 90s. So probably by the end of the week, or midweek, the fish will be used to it, and we'll be back on them. But we're getting to that good time of the day now, so I'm fishing till 9 o'clock. So we get one, great. We don't. We don't.
I'm good. I have to put
right there.
Oh.
No. Right there.
Close yeah, but on the
close them.
Yes, I don't have I have things in my mind. No, see, I tried that.
Well, that's, you know.
All right. Okay, well, you just proved you're smarter than me, all right? Fine.
You shouldn't have it right now here. All kinds of people don't know. You watch the pork chop? We're getting that time. Get that time. I can feel it coming.
For an hour and 15 minutes.
I feel it. I feel it. I feel it starting to, starting something starting to happen here.
This is not the spot we're going to Thursday. Absolutely not.
Yeah, the last time I fished down there, I fished underneath the train bridge. We got, the day I went down there, it was like a whole bunch of little tiny, tiny channel cats were hit. Like 1-pounders, but every single cast you were getting one. And a lot of white perch were hitting the day I was down. We were getting doubles. Doubles on the white perch. Yeah, it's definitely windy here today. Not cold, but it probably will get cold here in a little bit. Yeah, everything's posted on Accomack. You almost have to walk a creek down and fish the creek mouth. going to bed at 7:54. I wish I had my sweatshirt. The one thing I didn't bring.
Turn it off, speaker.
I cannot. Call me back.
Five hours of sleep. I got the bait that's not working, pork chop. At least it's not working yet. Ooh, no, that was a hit. That was a hit, pork chop. We got something messing around with it, pork chop. I think I have 5-aught and 6-aught hooks. I guess I'm only going for channel cats. Yeah, two of the hooks got chicken breast. Two of the hooks. Two of the rods, I should say, have chicken breast. The other two have something different. First rod keeps getting tapped. Actually, I do have my green coat. More like a windbreaker. I could probably put that on. first rest, I almost get hit like it's an eel, like an eel bite. Never caught an eel here, but they're here. Yeah, I don't mess around with that strawberry crap. All that does is get your fingers all red. And anything that you touch gets red. Anywhere you drop it gets red. I don't want to deal with that. You catch just as many without using that. All right, pork chop. What'd you say? Every time I go fishing, I gotta wait 3 hours and then I catch a fish, right? It was 2 hours and 44 minutes. So that means in 16 minutes, I should have a fish. We'll see if that works out again. So I guess Thursday, I'll just go 3 hours early. Well, Thursday we're having a little tournament. Myself versus Pork Chop on Hogleg's channel from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. That's why I came out bank fishing tonight. Tried this spot to see if it was any good. This does not look like it's going to be the spot that I fish Thursday. Oh, we have a guest. we have a guest. Hey, what's going on?
Hey, Jim here, Dam River Boys.
Okay.
I'm down here. We're at the Accomack.
Yeah.
I got my glasses on here so I can see what's going on. We got the Accomack Inn up here behind me.
Oh, yeah, it's, I know where you are.
About the only spot down here where it's not posted anymore. Just trying to figure out how to flip my camera around here. Or if I'm going to have to use it this direction.
You gotta press cam. I'm sorry, more. I think it's under more.
More. Well, I'll have a more. Settings, maybe settings. Camera.
Yeah. Then whatever one you're on, front or back, just switch to the other one. There you go.
Hold on. I think I can do... Number two facing front. Well, I guess I can on this stream. Okay. Let me get set up here.
Okay.
Again, look, find a spot.
Hey, you should see my tripod. It's held together with electrical tape.
Okay. Now, how good we're going to be here. I'm down to 20%, but it looks like I'm running on 5G, so we should be good with cell service.
Well, yeah, the picture looks real good.
Mind the picture good here?
Yep, I can see you good.
Okay. That's where I'll fish from then.
What do you got, some creek chubs?
How'd you guess? We got fall fish.
Even better.
Bait.
Yep. Yeah, you should get into a flathead.
No, I got, I don't know, like probably 2 dozen of them that size in there.
Yeah, I plan on coming down that way this weekend, but I'm going to go down to Aldred, probably.
I ought to just take the rest of the trip and go to Port Deposit.
I like Aldred.
All right, I used to fish there a lot. So I started going down to Port Deposit, and I really got hooked on that down there. Oh, my phone fell over.
Yeah, if you start doing a lot of streaming, just go to Walmart and get yourself that cheap tripod. It's like 15 bucks.
Because I am going to start streaming here.
Yeah, the cheap tripod, and then you'll, I don't know if it comes with the cell phone holder or not. I forget if I bought that separate or not.
I had it for my camcorder. I should have brought some tape with me. That should be pretty good there. Balls, I don't keep bumping that.
And you know, if you hold your cell phone sideways, it gives you the full picture then.
Okay. And I'll flip it over. It'll probably stand better. Let me get a rod out here first. Yeah, I wish I had had time to head up to York Haven.
Yeah, I think you're frozen right now, your picture.
I froze?
Yeah.
Okay. Give me. All right, am I back in?
Yep, you're in.
Okay. I wonder if my screen turned off, timed out. This well. Yeah, that should be better for you.
Yeah, you got to put your phone on portrait mode. It didn't turn. Your picture didn't turn with the phone. You're sideways now. And just two pairs of sweatpants on the back seat. They're big, but they're sweatpants. Hey. Yeah. Yeah, the only thing I got with me is that raincoat, which is like a windbreaker. I mean, I could put it on if I want to. But we're going to be going in like another 50 minutes. We have 49 minutes. Yeah, it's 8:11. Okay, you're back.
Okay.
But, oh, now you're gone. He's having problems with his phone. I can't believe this spot didn't produce yet. Usually always gets a couple fish out of here.
I told you, the spot for me, terrible spot.
No bugs at all because it's really windy here. Yeah, we'll hit that mud spot Thursday.
Oh, we are.
Yeah, I just didn't feel like walking down it today. Thursday, I'll walk down it. We'll leave extra early.
That's not where I'm taking.
I could, but I'm not gonna. Yeah, 9 o'clock. I'm gonna wrap it up here. Maybe I'll stop and get a pizza, I think. Just now?
Yeah.
Oh, over on the other side of the river. Let's see what's going on with this lights. You sit here and so. I put that there. Whoa. Yeah, the switch isn't even built into the little box. The invite. Okay. Let's see here. There you go.
There you go. I can't get it to flip.
And yeah, you got to go to your camera settings, like before you come into the stream, and hook it up for that. So you can turn it, you know.
Yeah.
On your phone. But that's all right. That's fine.
Hey, we can do this for now. Just let me get it wedged back in here. We're done.
You already cast it out.
Yeah, I got one out, and I got fish jumping right in front of me, up against the bank here. Right in the shallows.
There you go.
They're in here feeding. Mm-hmm. So hopefully that'll stay there.
Yeah, it looks good if it stays there.
Okay. I don't see the one rod. Oh, it didn't stay.
It fell down.
Find a different spot here for it. Able to
you got a tackle bag or something? Maybe you could put it up against your bag.
You know, I'll just lay it on a tackle. I did bring a bag with me.
Will you fish the mafia or no?
No. Nope, I don't. I don't get involved in any of that. I ain't the big tournaments.
Yeah.
I stay out of them. We good there?
Yeah, that's all right. Okay.
I got one sitting out there on the bottom. My other one, I'm going to float.
It's the best time of the day right now to get something right before night.
Nope. Boy, these are really lively. That's a really good stream behind my house to hold me.
You got a lot of wind down there?
None.
No, we got a lot of wind here.
It is beautiful out here.
Yeah, I probably got like a 10-mile-an-hour wind, constant.
pork chop, that's the plan. I go every night so I can find the spot I want to find. I think he said he keeps it in the creek. He has a creek by his house.
Yep.
I have a bait tank. It's like a 275-gallon tote tank.
Yeah, that real nice little real cold water spring stream that's behind me. I go about, I don't know, half mile down it, and I can start catching wild brook trout out of it.
Oh, wow.
Nice ball fish in it.
Yeah, I have a big creek right across the street from my house. Good for chubs and ball fish and suckers.
Last year, I pulled a 14-inch wild trout out of it. There's another line there.
Yeah, it's actually chilly here. It's getting chilly.
Oh, it is. It's. I couldn't ask for a better night down here.
Kind of reminds you of a fall night.
Yeah, this is like a fall night here. Reminds you of like in the fall.
How many did you get so far tonight?
We didn't get any.
None.
I'm at it 3 hours now.
Great now, it's a great time. The sun's starting to go down.
There you got a bass.
This is out here.
Yeah.
I know him in the shallows. I don't know if that was carp.
Zappy. That was a guy fishing down the river from me fishing for bass. He just got one.
Yeah, it could have been bass in here too with me. That were getting on top.
I mean, it would be really nice if it was no wind, but this wind is really kicking up here.
Yeah, I really wish I could have got in there at Accomack or at Wildcat Falls.
Yeah. Yeah, when I launch at Marietta, I go right over there by Wildcat and sit.
Yeah, we used to be able to go right out there and fish off the bank, and it was really, really good fishing there. Flatheads. That's where I caught my first flathead ever. Was it Wildcat?
Me too. So did I. First flathead I ever. The first one I ever caught was 33 pounds.
So we were out there, me and my dad, and we were waiting. I was probably up to about my waist. I was probably 8 years old, 7 or 8 years old. And the fish latched on, and it pulled me right out in the water. And he was laughing so hard at me. And he got one on right at the same time, and it yanked him out in the water. Huh. Both of us were fighting flatheads at the same time.
Yeah, they're strong. They're a strong fish.
They just keep on pulling. Well, I got something out here swimming around in the shallows at my bobber. I don't know if you can see my float out here in the water at all. It's red. And I keep on seeing the back of a fish swimming around it. So it must be really shallow in here.
Hey, Team David, how you doing?
And he is just swimming around it.
Yeah, I know there's carp down there, too. It could be carp.
I'm not quite sure what it is. Well, I'm waiting to see it take off. Hopefully, it'll take it.
Huh? Yeah.
Have you ever been down there at Port Deposit fishing for the blue cats?
Yeah, we fished right underneath the train bridge.
Oh, you got to go out on the flats.
Yeah, I never went down past the bridge.
You got to get past all the bridges out into the big water.
We went down there. We were in a pontoon boat when we went down.
Oh, you'd be just fine out there. Those wind speeds under 10 mile an hour. It's like the river is right here, right now. Calm as could be.
Yeah, how big of a blue cat did you get out of there?
I just started fishing it 2 years ago. My biggest one so far is 57 pounds down there.
How many pounds?
57.
57, wow. I didn't even know they got that big right there.
Oh, yeah. I got another guy that I meet down there a lot. He said he had a 69-pounder on last year. And it like the day before when I was there. I go down there like two or three times a week.
Now, is that still in the Susquehanna River or is that more into the bay?
That's more into the bay where I'm at. Where after you pass that last train bridge, that's where the Susquehanna ends.
Okay.
But they call it the Susquehanna Flats out there after the bridge. When you're down around Haverty Grass. And you got to watch it out there too because there's weed beds and the water will only be like 2 inches deep. You'll go from being like 7 foot to 1 foot in a matter of seconds down there.
Yeah, it's kind of like how the Potomac is, too. Once you get out of the channel, there's no water.
I guess that fish gave up on me out there. I don't see him swimming around my float anymore. My bait. Guess he just wanted to investigate the deer there. He's digesting it, and I don't know it.
Not 9 o'clock yet there, pork chop.
There's probably carp out there. It's Mark, still fooling around.
Mark outdoors. I don't see him in there. He didn't comment.
Your chat. He doesn't have that live chat button. I sent him my screen. I said, "It's on my chat."
Hey, he's gotta click that. You gotta get into the video, so the video's playing.
You have to play the video.
Yeah.
Tomorrow night, do I?
What'd you say?
I don't have a hole in my pants tonight, do I?
No, I can't see it. The screen's too small for me.
Yesterday, I was walking around with my rear end out. I didn't even know my pants were ripped. Luckily, I didn't go anywhere. Well, my wife came in and said, "I hope you didn't go anywhere. Were you walking around like that all day today?" Like, what are you talking about? Your rear end's out. I hope you didn't go anywhere.
Where are you going? Yeah, I probably should have fished the spot closer to my house where it's more of a mud.
Yeah, I would have liked to have been up and went up the York Haven to fish off the bank and got into the Little Conewago Creek. Helped out there in York Haven.
Well, if it's not raining tomorrow night at this time, I'm going to try it again tomorrow night. I try to go on around 5 o'clock, you know?
Yeah. I prefer fishing in the mornings, early, every evening.
I like sleeping in the morning.
I'm a morning person. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, I got up early today. I was up at like 5:30. But then I wound up working on the boat and doing stuff around the house. And
that's what I should have did today. Sit there a little bit.
Somebody in the chat wants to know what kind of rig you're using with the float.
Oh, actually, I'm using one of the floats that you would put, that you would normally have about 6 inches from your bait.
Yeah.
I'll double them up. Just use them as a bobber.
Oh, okay.
When I fish the flats, I rig both ways.
That way, some guys use a pool noodle as a float.
Yeah, I can suspend and be off the bottom however far I want to be.
Right.
Or I can drag the bottom. I usually do two rods one way and two the other way.
Yeah, I'm going to grab my coat. Getting really chilly here.
But yeah, they're just regular 3-inch foam float. The pins in there. Then you slide on your line. I have them in my bag here. I'd grab them and show them to you, but I don't want to move the phone. Did I get kicked out?
I'm just grabbing a ticket.
Okay. Uh-oh. I think I'm going to get booted out of here. My phone, I didn't have a very good charge on my phone.
Oh.
And this is really tearing it up.
Oh, okay.
And I didn't bring a pack with me, so hopefully I can get one here. Before
we'll try it again. We're going to try it again tomorrow night, so if you want to go in tomorrow, we'll be all...
I got a bite.
Uh-oh.
We got a rod moving. I see a fish out there swimming around. Am I still in here?
Yeah, you're still here.
Okay. Yeah, we got one in here slashing around. Check this rod. It's pulling. Hopefully he didn't clean me up in the other one. And he did.
It might be too small.
Same color. Oh. This is a 2X.
Summertime one. Not very thick.
No, it's on the other rod. The heck rod is what here? We got a mess.
Mark it in. I don't see him.
He's got to have the video playing. He's got to be signed into YouTube also. He might not be signed in. If he touches YouTube, the app on his phone, it's signed in automatically. Not the one. Set the window. The tag's the one. Just put it on the side. It's not hanging off the back, is it? It's only going to be here 25 more minutes.
Oh,
he does have an account. Everybody has. I made his thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, when we're on the boat. Can I make it Mark's Outdoors or something? Just tell him to touch his YouTube app. Yeah, tomorrow, pork chop. I'm going to fish the other spot tomorrow. I still think I'm going to pick one up here, though, before 9. One or two. I'm going to start my car up. It's like an hour. 3 hours, you know? Another one.
Come on. That was a big one. His pole was bent.
Yeah.
He hooked up down there. Oh man, that's awful. Oh, I feel bad. Go back and get him.
You will. Bass are hitting.
I like his enthusiasm. That's how I am.
We can start rearranging this a little bit in here. I'll give you 20 more minutes. No, Ashley, we're trying to catch something, but our weather just changed here, so I don't know what it did to the catfish, but they're not here. I guess I'm in the wrong spot tonight. But the guy right down the river from me is catching the bass.
Oh, yeah. You probably heard him cursing. He's trying. Take your mark.
Put my bait away. No, I'm not changing the name of the bait. Oh, the bridge lights came on. We'll see, pork chop. We'll see. I actually have a lake I could go to that has a lot of channel cats in it. But it's a little bit of a drive from my house. It takes me about, a good 45 minutes to get to that lake. But it's a possibility I may just go down there. Last time we were at that lake, we caught 2 13-pound channel cats and a 12-pound channel cat. So that's a possibility that I'll go down to that lake. So that was 2 years ago, maybe 3 when I caught them. And I put them back in, so they're probably 15 pounds now. I don't think anybody keeps the channel cats out of that lake. I think everybody throws them back.
You okay? $5.
Yeah, I'll check your channel out too when I get home. Remember, pork chop, you went to a pay lake and got skunked. You got skunked at a pay lake.
Are you picking on
pork chop? I'm at a river.
Don't be picking on pork chop.
In the chat.
You don't want.
He's keeping track of the time. 15 more minutes. Porkchop, you should be out there fishing.
Yeah, that's right, Bullets. He was. He'll tell you it was because of the rain. He said it rained and he had to leave. I wasn't talking about C.J. Brown. I was talking about when you went to the Pay Lake and you said you got skunked. And then you said it was because it was raining and that you left. Okay, Ashley, I'm only going to be on for until 9 o'clock. Pork Chop will tell you that's 13 more minutes. Then you know what? Maybe I'll go to Long John Silver's on my way home. What do you think of that, Pork Chop? Guess the catfish didn't want to come out and play today. Watch out, Bullets. He'll be calling you out next. You'll be on his list. He'll call you out for a 1v1. Oh boy. Looks like the turtle lady wants a shot at your pork chop too.
I can't noodle this year because of my back surgery.
Eight more minutes, pork chop. Let's see if a rod goes down. Only takes a minute.
I saw you lost a biggie over there. Your pole was bent.
What was that, a big smallmouth?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Two times nice. Bigger than that one.
Yeah.
I know. I saw your pole. I was like,
yeah.
You had him like almost to the bank.
I've been fighting with that sinfish. That's why every time I come here, I go right there.
Yeah. You're getting
I'm live on YouTube right now.
Oh, wow. Like, we do from online, like,
I know.
Two, three times. Broke okay. My white fishing pole.
Oh,
that
wow.
Same fish. Oh, man.
That must
good
be where he
guys.
Hangs out. You right. Know?
Yeah.
You'll get him.
Yeah, we're only going to be here a few more minutes.
That's awesome, though.
Yeah.
The same fish all the time for him.
That's what keeps you coming back, those big ones breaking you off.
He'll get him.
Huh?
Hey, what's up?
Huh? Can't hear it. No trailer?
No.
Okay.
That's the best.
Oh, okay. Is that motor?
Yeah. The motor hit the block.
Yeah. I think it's sinking.
I think it might be. If they just figure it out there, there's no trailer.
We'll see that when we go up.
This is interesting.
That is interesting. If somebody yes. They just launched the boat here without a boat trailer.
Yeah.
They carried the boat down the launch and put it in.
And bang.
And it's not a small boat.
No.
It's probably like a 17-foot boat.
I can't believe that.
He's almost in my frame. Turn my camera just a hair so you can see the boat.
They hit that hard.
Yeah, see, I can't zoom in, but he's out there. Yeah, he's still moving. Sure does look low in the back, though.
Oh my God, does it ever?
Hey, four more minutes and I'm going to pack it up.
I can't go anymore.
I think he's waiting for someone else to come down and go.
Three more minutes. Watch, pork chop. Right in the last minute, a rod is going to get slammed. You watch. You watching?
Pick up your chair over there. Put it away. Get your bait, put it away.
Yeah, they are. You never know what's going to happen at this launch.
I just don't know how they got that boat here. There's no way that could have been on the back of a pickup truck. Ooh, get your stuff. Come on. Get your chair. Get your bait. Get your chair. Get your bait. Let's go. Looks like a boat trailer to me. Oh, okay. I think he just came in hard.
No, he didn't. No.
Two more minutes, pork chop. No, I didn't get I didn't get your fish. I wish I did. And I would never boot you or anyone. It cut out before it happened. But what did you get? Damn river boys, what did you get? Was it channel cats or flatheads or what? One more minute, pork chop. Tomorrow will be a different spot. Oh, time's up. All right, hey, thanks everybody that came in. Sorry we didn't catch any fish, but we tried. Catches all tomorrow. Good night.